no cap to y'all, cause I went there when they ain't had a ball. He talking sporty, wonder how he felt watching his dog casket fall. I had to tell my wife to stop, he don't like to pass the ball.
From a city that has hosted 10 Super Bowls, here's a look inside the Caesars Superdome in New Orleans. The setting in this dome just serves to amplify the excitement of the folks in New Orleans as their Saints burst from the tunnel a moment ago. They're set, and we're set as well as the Saints get ready to do battle with the Miami Dolphins. Kicker for the Saints, Will Lutz, has it teed up, and here we go from New Orleans. And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25. Get 11 as they get a quick first down. That O-line, they cleared a big hole there on that run.
The athleticism of offensive lines continues to evolve, and we're seeing it here. Not only are they controlling things right at the line of scrimmage, but they're able to get upfield to get to what we call the second and the third levels. You know, get to the linebacker spot, the secondary spot, getting all the way downfield with their blocking, which helps keep the running back clean.
They'll try to continue that trend here this afternoon. So from the 36 now, first and 10. Now it's Nwangu, and he sneaks his way forward only for a couple here. Second down. Well done to sniff that out defensively. He had it diagnosed pretty quickly.
I love that description because diagnosed is perfect on that one. Read his keys, made the play, and he couldn't even get going moving the football.
The last run good for two. Here's second and eight. On the give is Nwangu. They give those 2 yards right back, and now they're looking at a third and 10.
Well, coaches stress their defense being physical. They don't just mean the big guys. How about the guys on the outside, the cornerbacks? It's not just their job to patrol the airspace. They can get involved in the run game as well.
And for the Saints here on third down, an extra defensive back on the field. They go play action now. Jackson. Toward the sideline. Did he keep the feet in? Yes, he got them both down, says the side judge. And that's good enough for a first down. A big play there for the Dolphins.
Well, things are looking pretty darn good on this first drive, aren't they? Came right out, set the tone, this time with a big pass play.
And if the peek behind the curtain that they gave us for their game plan, I don't think that's going to be the last one we see.
I think you're exactly right about that.
On first down, they'll run to Nwangu. And he'll be a couple yards shy of the red zone here at the 22-yard line. Give him 10 yards on the pickup, and it'll be second and very short.
It's second and inches.
Hand off here to Nwangu, and he'll be brought down at the 21, just shy of the 20 in the red zone.
Second and inches is oftentimes an invitation for an offense coordinator to take a big shot downfield because he feels like he can come back on third down and pick up the first down. But sometimes you just don't want to break tendency. Stay with what you are. Stay with who. You know, and go get the first down. That's exactly what they did.
The run is Nwangu. And he's going to get this one down inside the 15. A good run, got seven on first. Here's second and three. Now a handoff here to his running back. And now they're inside the 10 as he's brought down at the 9.
I hope we give enough respect to the big guys up front because they have been getting it done on this drive. The holes have been large, and they've been barreling through them, picking up first downs.
And now Jackson will look to throw it. They'll roll him out right. He's got a man. It's his fullback. That catch good for only a couple.
He was out there waving his arms. And when you got a quarterback out of the pocket looking for any help, I guess waving the arms is helpful.
It certainly is because you got to get his attention because now you're in scramble drill. So everyone's adjusting their routes, finding open space, and he found the right spot for the completion.
The line of scrimmage, the 7 now on second and goal. Closer as he takes it from the 7 down to the 4-yard line. Driven it down the field nicely here on the opening drive, but now it's put up or shut up.
No doubt about it, because to make that type of a drive and ultimately kick a field goal would feel very disappointing. But I'm just wondering, is the head coach thinking, is this 4-down territory?
And he'll take this into the end zone for a Dolphins touchdown. Kenne Nwangu taking it in from 4 yards out. And the Dolphins are on the board here first in the season opener. Extra point up and good by Sanders. And it's now a 7-0 game. Now after the touchdown, ready to kick it away is Sanders. This is going to be returned from the middle of the end zone. And no chance to get away as they'll get him down at about the 17-yard line. So from the 17 now, here's a first and 10.
The first carry now, this is Alvin Kamara. And he's got it past the 30 before he's hit and dropped.
A gain of 15 yards.
Running with Kamara. And fights through one man. And he'll get this only up to about the 35. A gain of 3, second down.
Well, that's just a pile of bodies there, and that's when you kind of find out who's a tough guy, right? Who can stand up and make a play. It was only a 3-yard run. But for both sides, they had to walk away from that feeling like, okay, I can stand up when the going gets tough in here.
On second down, Kamara. And this defense not giving him anything there. Maybe a yard up to the 36.
We talk about defenders, specifically linebackers, keeping their eyes in the right spot. He had that eye down the entire time.
And you know that's not easily done because they throw a lot of misdirection at you. They try and fool you and get your eyes in the wrong place. But you're right about that one. He correctly figured that one out and made a really nice play.
To throw on third down, Huggins. Toward the sideline. Did he keep the feet in? Yes, he got them both down, says the side judge. And that's good enough for a first down.
And that's how you pick up a first down. Not only does he make the catch, but has enough body control to get his feet down inbounds, toe tapping and dragging to make sure he gets it done.
Here's a run on first down that doesn't accomplish anything. In fact, he's going to be tackled behind the line for a loss of one.
I thought he did a nice job there setting an edge and make sure nothing could get to the outside. But he decided that wasn't enough for him. Worked his way back inside and made the tackle on the ball carrier.
Second and 11 now. And here's Kamara on the read option. Two runs in a row, but only 2 yards to show for it. After one, 7-0 on EA Sports.
And now on third down, they'll need to get it to the 36 to pick up the first. Looking to throw, Huggins. Trying to improvise. And he'll go out of bounds right around the 40. He'll wind up getting 4 yards there on his own, but it also brings up fourth down.
Okay, he's not going to get the first down, but this is still a nice job of buying some time and then running to get to the sideline and get out of bounds and avoid the big hit.
So now on comes the field goal unit, and wow, this is no ordinary try here. They'll spot it at the 47, so call it a 57-yard attempt. And this is good from 57 yards out. That was bombs away right there. So yes, it's only 3, but at least they're able to answer back after giving up the touchdown to start the game.
Yeah, I like the observation there because getting some points on the board, very positive for them. Feel a little bit better about things because if you don't score, you potentially have opened the door for them to score again, and then you're down 14.
The Dolphins at the line ready for their next drive. They had the touchdown on the opening drive of the ball game. It was countered by just a field goal. So, hey, if your guys can do that for 4 quarters, you're in good shape.
Yeah, it is a team game, so that's just good complimentary football. But, you know, I know I'm no brainiac, but you trade 6s for 3s, things are going to work out in your favor.
45 yards rushing for him now to this point.
So they'll come up after the gain of 7 on a 2nd and 3. Play action. It's Jackson. Taking a deep shot here for Hardman. And that's going to be incomplete. Good effort there, trying to take a shot, but it's third down.
And you just know when that play call came in, their eyes lit up, because anytime you get a chance to take a big shot downfield, that's a lot of fun, and they missed an opportunity.
So the incomplete pass on the last play, and that leads us to a 3rd and 3. Now a give running right, Nwagu. And he's got the first before he's brought down at the 39-yard line. So from the 39 now, they'll come up on a 1st and 10. Jackson. He'll get this to Nwagu. And he'll be taken down, but not before he works it past the 50.
One of my old teammates called me the other day when he was watching the game. He's like, man, trying to watch an NFL game and trying to account for their passing game, that's difficult. And just when you think you get everything covered, here comes a back out of the backfield. And in this case, he picks up a 1st down.
So in Saints territory now, here's 1st and 10 at the 47. On the pickup there, and it'll be 2nd down.
Give credit to the defense for stringing that play out, and they gave up no cutback angle. You know he was trying to dart through. No place for him to go. A nice job there, only giving up a 3-yard gain.
Second and six. No, scratch that. 2nd and 7. They go play action with Jackson. He'll take a shot for the end zone. And, oh, that would get a write-up incomplete. Nearly an interception in the end zone. Probably should have been. 3rd down coming up.
7 yards to go.
The Dolphins on 3rd down. A perfect 3 for 3 as they look to keep that streak going. This is 3rd and 7. Jackson now. To the right and complete to Galladay. And he'll get this to the 40, but that's still going to be a few yards short of the 1st down. Umpire threw the flag, usually always indicates holding, and that's what we've got.
And you know, depending on their positioning, where you are on the field, the umpire's got different responsibilities, but always, always making sure no one's holding.
And this 3rd down looking very tough after the holding penalty. 3rd and long. Throwing is Jackson. And this pass broken up. The contact well timed there, and now 4th down. On 4th down, Michael Pilardi on to punt. We'll call that a punt of 38 yards officially, and the Saints will take over with a 1st down and 10. Getting set for their next drive, the New Orleans offense. They finished off their opening drive of the campaign with a field goal on the last drive. Now they'll search for a touchdown here on this go-around. 1st and 10. Throw left side complete to Troutman. And he gets it here to right around the 24 before he's out of bounds. A gain of 6 there on 1st.
And there's a completion to the tight end. And look at the size of these players nowadays. At that spot, 6'4", 6'5", and up. A lot of guys used to be basketball players, somehow came back to football. That's really good for the game of football. You get better athleticism, great hand-eye coordination, guys who know how to control their bodies when they run their routes.
And the Saints, 1st down. 1st and 10 at the 35-yard line.
And they run the option here on 1st and 10. And he went nowhere. Well, he went backwards, back to the 33. 2 yards the loss, 2nd and 12. Well, that play never really got off the launching pad. He had a linebacker in his face before he had a chance to do much of anything.
Yeah, I think it's big boys up front, that offensive line. They've got to do a little bit better job of protecting him if they're going to continue to run the option like this.
Now it's Kamara in the passing game. And he'll go out near midfield at the 49.
We can talk all we want about football being a game of strength and brawn. It's also a game of mismatches, and they're trying to create one there, getting it to their back out of the backfield to make a bigger play.
As we often say, get it to him in space, let him use his leg.
Yeah, if he can get a matchup against a linebacker or maybe a defensive end dropping out in a zone blitz, he's going to win that battle just about every time.
Two first downs, have them up near midfield now on first and 10. A gain of 3, second down.
It's a pickup of 3. Brings up second and 7.
Operating from the gun, Huggins. That's complete, Bernard. And he is out of bounds inside the 35.
I do have to admit, I like it when it all comes together. When the top part, catching the football, right, whether you're catching it with your hands or cradling it, comes together with the legs, in this case, the feet, doing a little toe tap to stay in bounds and complete the catch.
And a great job by our crew on the camera shot. Love when you see the grass or on the field turf, those rubber pellets flying up. Great catch. And Kamara with a call on first down as he works his way forward for a gain of about 6.
That's a strong pickup right there on first down. And as this drive goes on, we're seeing an offensive line and running game imposing its will.
The last run got 6, now 2nd and 4. Back to throw. Huggins to the right side and complete to Thomas. That reception, it brings him up to the 700 plateau. He's at 700 career NFL catches now.
And that club in baseball, a rather exclusive club, and one we talk about all the time, in football, puts you in the top 50 all-time range. Not so bad either.
Now a first down carry. It's Kamara, and he'll take it down here just shy of the 15 at the 16-yard line. Following the pickup of 4, here's 2nd and 6. Looking to throw, Huggins. And he just chucked that one out of bounds, out of everyone's reach. Maybe a wise call not to take a sack in this part of the field. It brings up 3rd down.
To this point, I've been impressed with the work defensively. They have not allowed a lot of receivers to run free. And there's another example, another incompletion.
So after the 2nd down incompletion, they'll come up now against a 3rd and 6. Back to throw. Huggins. To the goal line, but it's incomplete. More problems here on 3rd down. They've converted only once so far in this first half.
And you know as well as I do in this league, if you don't win on 3rd down, it makes it hard to win a ball game because then you're relying on your defense, you're relying on your special teams. You've got to get it done with your offensive unit.
No problems in the field goal department so far. He's 2 for 2.
Pretty reliable here in this game, isn't he? And to me, that bodes well for them. If they need him late in the game, his confidence should be sky high.
And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25. The Dolphins at the line, ready for their next drive, as they will take over here with a little more than 30 seconds remaining. Now whistles and a flag, and I believe the Dolphin got going a little early. Start backs him up 5, 1st and 15. Now Jackson drops this off with DeWandre. And he stopped right at the 25 after a gain of 5. Now the Dolphins going to burn the first of their timeouts as they stop it with 28 seconds to go in the first half of play. Looking to throw again on second down. Jackson. He'll find Nwangu underneath. And they work this well upfield across the 45. The Dolphins going to take their second timeout as they stop it with 19 seconds to go in half number one. From the gun, they'll try to run it. And he's going to take this across the 50 and into Saints territory. Now the Dolphins will use the last of their timeouts as they'll stop it with 14 seconds to go in this first half. Off the play fake, here's Jackson. That'll be incomplete with 9 seconds now showing on the clock.
A lot of times it's that first read that you have. Maybe you get it in pre-snap and he locked in on his target, but he was covered quite well and that one's incomplete.
Now they face a third down and 4 after that incompletion on second down. Play action. Now Jackson. And it's incomplete. Took a shot, couldn't connect.
Has to be a little bit of frustration there. Back-to-back incompletions. Receivers blanketed on both attempts. This time on third down.
And on fourth down, on is the punt team sending this one away. And no return here. This one's going inside the 15 to the 12-yard line. So we've reached halftime here on opening weekend as we send you on over to Orlando for Jonathan Coachman in our EA Sports Halftime Report. Take it away, Coach.
Okay, Coach, thanks as always. This one's still anyone's game as we welcome you back for quarter number 3.
We'll see if week one fatigue becomes any kind of a factor as we are back underway in the second half. The Dolphins at the line ready for their next drive. We have not seen much on offense from either side these last few drives. It has been a struggle, hasn't it?
Totally, and you're thinking to yourself right now, if you're on offense trying to get things figured out, okay, we self-scout every week in our game plan. How many things do we do at certain times? What are our tendencies? Time to go to some of those tendency breakers and try and create some offense.
They always have those in their back. Gets by him, and now a little daylight. And all the way in for a Miami touchdown.
Just a terrific run there, Charles, from a running back who is so compact and powerful. And that strength was on display there.
Yeah, and this is one of the best runs you'll see. A lot of times on these long touchdowns, you'll see he gets into the end zone untouched, but not here. He fought his way through contact, and it barely even registered. And he just continued down the field all the way to the end zone.
This will be brought out from the middle of the end zone. And he will be brought down here inside the 20. Good coverage as he's dropped at the 17. The Saints offense on the field ready to get their drive started. They're kind of searching for that magic elixir. You know, they're moving the football a little bit, but not with any great consistency.
I love that term you just used, elixir, right?
Old school.
Old school, I love that. Because you don't want to put too much pressure on your defense as well, all right? If you're kicking field goals, that's great, but your defense has to keep going out there and holding the other team. You're not giving them any cushion to work with, and that gets tougher and tougher as the game goes along. Put the ball in the end zone and get sixes. That's the ambrosia that they're looking for.
Ambrosia, and trying to erase this deficit. And he'll get only a couple up to the 22.
Typically, we think it's the strong safeties that are better tacklers, especially closer to the line of scrimmage amidst traffic. But in this case, how about the free safety coming up and making the big-time play?
from the gun on third down. Huggins. And he is out of bounds right around the 34.
Would it be safe to say that as precise as routes are supposed to be run in the NFL, maybe they're not quite as precise in college ball?
That's accurate, yeah.
And I think we saw a college route in the NFL there. Just find the soft spot, find the dead zone, and find the first down. And that's what he just did.
Throwing on first down, Huggins. Here's Johnson with a reception. And he is out of bounds inside the 35. A big play that time through the air. 32 yards. So the big play changes the complexion of things. Here's first and 10 just outside the 30. Looking to throw. Huggins. Flush to his right. And he'll just get rid of it.
Well, defensively, they haven't let him just sit in the pocket and get comfortable. And that's opposite a lot of game plans in today's NFL. Ordinarily, you're trying to keep the quarterback hemmed in. In this case, they brought the heat. And if he flushes out, they're fine with that. And they force another incompletion.
They'll stick with the passing game as he looks to throw. This is complete to Michael Thomas. And he's going to get this down near the 20-yard line.
Now what we're seeing, this is much better from this offense because so far in this game, no touchdown to this point. And what's usually a direct correlation? Very few explosive plays. That's been their issue. Not able to make that big shot downfield or break one off. But a nice game there for a first down.
They'll look to throw again. And this turns into a nice gain with a slide at the end.
First and goal at the 7-yard line.
Try to pound it in, Kamara. And he'll be stopped just outside the 5 at the 6. The 6-yard line, the line of scrimmage on second and goal.
It's a gain of a yard. Brings up second and goal at the 6-yard line.
Kamara trying again. And a minuscule gain of maybe a yard from the 6 to the 5. Two straight shots on the ground. Now on third, do you go to the air?
I think the possibility exists. And if you're doing it, you're probably going play action since you ran it twice. But I often think that second down is a time you go play action and throw the ball. I say commit to the run and think about it being 4-down territory.
A 4-yard pickup, not enough. Fourth down. He's been quiet today in the passing game, just his second catch.
Yeah, and people have to come up with schemes to limit him. And what a lot of teams do, they'll double him, you know, use a linebacker underneath, a safety over the top. Sometimes they'll just take a corner, maybe their third corner if he's a bigger guy, and put him on a man-to-man to try and limit his touches. Just keep mixing it up, give him different angles, different looks, like a good boxer does.
And he'll take it into the end zone for the Saints touchdown. Miles Gaskin taking it in from a yard out. And the Saints move back within a couple of the lead.
This defense held out as long as they could, but ultimately the running game wears them down from the 1-yard line.
And that gets set up throughout the entire drive, doesn't it? And when you put those big bodies and determination into that carry, the end result, touchdown.
He hits the big target for the 2-point try. Defenses hate those guys, especially around the goal line.
It's hard to decide who you're going to put on him. Are you going to put a smaller corner on him? Are you going to put a safety who doesn't have maybe the same coverage skills? How about a linebacker? He may have the size, but he's not used to really covering in space. That's why the tight end gives you such a great advantage when you're throwing the football.
The Dolphins at the line ready for their next drive. And their lead has evaporated in this third quarter. It's tied once more as they begin with a first and 10. First plays a run with Nwangu. And he'll maneuver his way forward for about 4. Second and 6.
they'd love to just strike back with a touchdown right here. And if it's a long play, so be it. But the main goal, get a couple of first downs, run some plays, run some clock, allow their defense to get a chance to catch their breath, settle down, and relax a little bit after they just gave up the score.
Taking a deep shot here for Hardman. Got a man, it's caught at the 6-yard line. And he takes it down deep into enemy territory. It's a big play there for Miami. They'll try and run for it on first and goal. They'll say no gain on the play, and it'll be second and goal.
As usual, the hallmark of a good run defense, linebackers making plays near the line of scrimmage. Absolutely nowhere to run there.
Line of scrimmage, again the 4-yard line, second and goal. Jackson from the shotgun. Touchdown! Kenny Galladay from 4 yards out. And the Dolphins have taken the lead. Extra point up and good by Sanders. And the lead is now 21-14.
Saints 14.
Now after the touchdown, ready to kick it away is Sanders. And there will not be a return here. It's a touchback, and it'll come out to the 25-yard line. Getting set for their next drive, the New Orleans offense. And that last drive, a long drive, but not just that. They had a great air attack going. Do they stick with that?
I would think that they would, because if they were confident enough to do it on the last drive, starting backed up in their own territory, why would you change anything? They've got to be confident about what they're presenting and continue to do so.
Yeah, because the secondary, they really look clueless.
And that was amazing, because that drive went and went, no adjustments and no big plays by the defense.
The Dolphins get there this time, and they bring him down. Jalen Phillips in there to get him. It's a loss of 5. And that is going to do it for this third quarter of action. We'll return with more after this. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. Coming up now on a 2nd and 15 following that sack. A throw there, but that's going to wind up incomplete.
You could tell they wanted to get that ball downfield, but they had nothing working in the secondary, so he dropped it off to the running back. That one ended up incomplete.
The Saints on 3rd down, 2 for 5 to this point. This will be 3rd and 15. Back to throw. Huggins. He finds his man, Johnson. And he is going to have a Saints 1st down as they're able to get the 3rd down conversion.
I like the design that we're seeing right there. This is what they need. Down by a touchdown here in the 4th. They just need to keep working their way downfield. And when they see openings, take their shots.
On 1st down, Huggins. And a quick throw here. That's complete. Working with a 2nd and 3. Again, he'll drop to throw. Completing it to the right side, Johnson. And he'll be out of bounds about a half to a full yard shy of the 5. A big connection on that one. 33 yards. Every defensive staff harps on limiting explosive plays. Job not so well done there.
Yeah, they talk about it all the time. A lot harder to stop, though, isn't it? And when you think of an explosive play, most offensive staffs define them as passes of 20 or more yards and runs of 15 or more yards.
They went zooming past that number there.
Again, Kamara. And this is not going to do it as he stopped at the 2-yard line.
It'll go. It's no gain on the play, and now they're looking at a third and goal.
His path became similar to almost running a stretch play, didn't it? Trying to find a crease, anywhere to put his foot in the ground and cut back. It just never materialized.
And Gaskin, I don't think he got there. No, they're going to mark him short. Now the Dolphins going to burn the first of their timeouts. It's just their first. They'll be down to two remaining as we step aside here in the fourth quarter. Likely the play of the game here, trailing in the final quarter and going for it on fourth and goal. And he takes it across and into the end zone. Touchdown, Saints. Myles Gaskin, already his second touchdown here in this opening weekend. And the Saints are an extra point away from tying this game here in the fourth. Will Lutz on for the point after. And no sweat, he puts it through, and we are tied here in the fourth. Couple of teams locked into a good one here. 21 all the score as the kick's away. And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25. The Dolphins at the line ready for their next drive. After the long touchdown drive we just saw, you wonder if maybe that's taken a little of the wind out of this offensive sails, because they had it going pretty good last time, too. He's got a man complete. Yeah, he's got to be out of bounds, but not before he takes it inside the 40. A big play there for the Dolphins.
Well, partner, I'm not sure how this drive's going to end, but how about the way they flip field position there? A nice attacking play. They picked up a heck of a chunk of yardage.
So how about that for a chain mover? They're all the way down inside the 40 now for first and 10. They'll run with Nwagu, and they will only muster a yard here to the 38.
Well, sometimes you just have to give credit to the defense. Great job there at the point of attack, holding up. They won their battles at the line of scrimmage, left him no space to try and run. Really nice job swarming to the ball carrier.
He lets this one fly toward the back of the end zone. And that will be incomplete. Tried to dial up the long one way out there, but it'll be third down.
I know you felt like saying touchdown there, didn't you, partner? That looked like a sure 6 points, but the contact jarred it free.
Got his hands on it, could not hold on through the end of the play. Third down, trying to get a little bit closer. From here, the field goal would be 55 yards. Here's Jackson to throw. Taking a deep shot here for Hardman. And it's intercepted at the goal line. Picked off with great anticipation. And the Saints are going to have the football here at their own 18-yard line. Well, we say it often, Charles, but not all interceptions are created equally. And that is a big one here in a tie ball game in the fourth quarter.
And Brandon, when games are this close, it usually comes down to the team making the fewest mistakes. And that was one of our mantras back at Tennessee. Coach Major say all the time, the team making the fewest mistakes will win. You've got to cut those down to give yourself an opportunity.
The Saints offense on the field, ready to get their drive started. And he's tackled a yard short of the marker. Good gain of 9 on first down.
First play of the drive, let's give credit all around. Excellent blocking, but the guy carrying the ball, he was the finisher. A really nice run.
The last run got 9. That leaves him with 2nd and a yard. They'll give to Kamara here on the option, and he'll be brought down right at the 30 here.
Second and one is often an invitation to take the big shot downfield. I'll bet the offensive linemen said, are you kidding? We just get on our backs and let's go get the first down. They love being physical.
Just week one, but already plenty of intrigue with the games going on, and this one no different as we come up on a first and 10. Here's Kamara on the read option. And he'll be taken down, but not before they work it across midfield. So now first and 10 as they've crossed into Miami territory at the 48-yard line. He'll air it out deep for Thomas. And this one is incomplete.
They've given up a few first downs on this drive, but getting the incompletion there, that should give them something to build on and maybe turn the tide.
Here's second and 10. They'll give to Kamara here on the option. And they'll get this just to the 47, 1 yard gain. But not much on that run, Charles.
No, that's exactly the way to execute a run blitz there. They guessed correctly that they would move the ball on the ground, honed in on it, and stopped them. Marked that down for a win in the defense's column.
A field goal from this spot likely out of the question. They've got to get closer here on third down. Looking to throw. Huggins. And a throw there going to be incomplete. When they need to play on third down, you kind of know what direction the ball's going, but the defense knew it too.
Yeah, it's a good call because they wanted to put two men on him, and they did. Dare him to throw into double coverage. Really what you're saying is, let's see if one of your other receivers can beat us.
On fourth down, the punt team is on as this is sent away. All tied up, less than 2 minutes to go. So the Dolphins have it as we welcome you back in. The Dolphins at the line ready for their next drive. And in enemy territory last time through the interception. We'll see what they do on this drive.
Can't wait to see how it alters what they decide to do in play calling. Do they continue to throw the ball? Do they want to lean more on the running game? It'll be an interesting sequence of plays that they've got coming up.
Does it often affect the play calling with the interception? How much does that change what you do?
I think it does depending on why the interception was thrown. Sometimes it's just a matter of the defense made a great play, so you continue to come back. But if it's on you, if the offense just doesn't have the confidence, if they're a little bit shaky, maybe try and take the pressure off and run the ball a little bit.
And this is going to be intercepted. Chauncey Gardner-Johnson with a pick. And they'll have great field position here as the ball will be at the 15-yard line. When you're on your own 1 yard line like they were, oftentimes you're thinking just run on any down, get some space. There they elect to throw it. It cost them.
You get the sense that they were banking on the element of surprise, right? Everyone expects you to run it there. Let's take a shot. Let's throw it. Try and create some space, some room. And it went awry, didn't it?
Here's Kamara on the read option. He will push his way down to about the 14. Just a yard on the first down carry, so it's second and 9.
I like it. I like the call. Still an opportunity to run the football and chew up a little more time off the clock.
Here's second and 9, just a yard on that last run. They'll give to Kamara here on the option. And he'll get this one down to about the 10-yard line. The Dolphins going to take their second timeout as the clock's going to stop with 47 seconds to go in the fourth. On third down, here's Kamara. He didn't get the touchdown, but he did get the first down as he's tackled at the 1.
101 yards rushing for him now as he goes over the century mark here in the season opener.
Now the Dolphins will use the last of their timeouts as they'll stop it with a little over 30 ticks to go in the football game. Game-winning field goal would be a chip shot from here. Let's see how they play it on first and goal. And here's another kneel down as he'll try to set up the game winner. Now we'll get a quick timeout called by New Orleans, number two, as it'll come with 15 seconds to play in the ballgame. Second and goal, and they will try again from the 2-yard line. They'll run it with Kamara. And he gets halfway there, down to the 1-yard line. And with just inside of 10 seconds to go, they'll burn their final timeout. 9 seconds left. So it all rests now on the right leg of Will Lutz. 2 for 2 on the afternoon, and a third one winner. And his kick is indeed good. And it's celebration time on that sideline as they have taken the lead in the final seconds. And you know, in an era of cost-cutting and maximizing your roster, this is a club that does not skimp on special teams, and in these situations, it pays dividends.
And that's great vision by the organization. When the difference between winning or losing depends on who you have kicking the ball, would you rather have a street free agent out there or a solid pro like this? Answer's pretty evident to me.
Dolphins at the line, ready for their next drive. Look at the clock. Everyone knows the situation. Probably time here for one final play.
Oh, for the third time, Jackson going to be intercepted.
Picked off at the 36. And he will take this one home. It's a touchdown. And so much for the game-winning 2-minute drive. I think that interception return there pretty much seals the deal.
And one thing to keep in mind, in this situation with the score that close, defense isn't backing off and just giving you easy throws. They're playing aggressively as well.
I like it.